Hello folks and welcome. Today we will be unlocking the Lycanthrope class and playing with it. And the character we will be building will be a Lycanthrope. Let's play a Lycanthrope Animist, since we didn't get to see the Animist skills, rather than play with this class in a draft mode. And for the Lycanthrope, we care in particular about slashing and bludgeoning, as well as a bit of earth. And for the Animist, piercing, bludgeoning and earth. So we will be focusing to increase our slashing, bludgeoning and earth. And if you can see now, there is this tooltip here that tells you which attribute affect what without having to go here and read this text. So I will increase my agility and resilience and strength, and also set my intellect to 15 to increase earth and also benefit from the increased hand size. And this is the stats we'll be using for this particular build. I'll pick a more lycanthrope looking dude. He looks perfect lycanthrope. And I will be playing in the casual mode. So let's take a look in our skills. And this unwilling transformation will be causing your character to randomly, not exactly randomly, whenever you are drawing this card, to assume his hybrid form and turn into a werewolf, which in turn make him be able to use only cards with the primal descriptor, like for example sixth sense, close strike, and other cards that are currently locked. So whenever he draws as a lycanthrope non-primal cards, he will be discarding them, but in return you will be getting these powerful feral strike cards. So let's play with the current deck as is, the starting deck of this combination, and see how it will go. So the key about primal is that each time you are playing a primal card, your primal slashing, for example, damage will get to increase. Slashing damage plus one. So the more primal cards you have in your deck, the better your lycanthrope will be performing. Let's also use the ceremonial mask so we can get the retribution and kill this spider as it attack us. I will also turn on the verbose mode plus the numerical key. And if you notice, we draw the unwilling transformation card and we turned into our hybrid form, and this transformation will last for two more rounds. Continue. So any card that I draw and it's not primal is getting discarded, and we are left only with the primal cards. And we can also use this card here to get this primal plus 4 and then right click. No, it won't work. As I remember, if you remember, as I told you, defensive stance doesn't trigger the synergies, only if the ally ability actually crafts a card that will trigger this. But we can still right click on our ally and get defend 3, retribution 3 at the cost of 4 hit points and minus 1 lifespan, so he will disappear. turn. So now we will be reverting back to our human form, right in time for an event. And there is this mad bot here that's about to suicide, and we can push him or save him or just leave. I will actually try to save him and add him to my deck. Let's play Animal Instinct. As the more primal slashing cards you play, the more this primal slashing damage and all your slashing damage cards will get. But also now this animal ally here has a primal piercing of 3, thanks to this synergy right here. So if you notice this wall of vines, it has a primal bludgeoning, which will be more beneficial because then it will also increase this bludgeoning damage here. So I can use wall of vines like so, get the bludgeoning damage bonus, and just do something with my boar and use the feral strike in the con artist. Bleeding will done complete the job for us, and now we can move onward. Open the chest. Let's get the spiked club and the bomb. So he didn't attack. If he had, if our entangle hadn't worked, teamwork stun, teamwork vulnerable. Now I'm just using to attack and continue. Let's finish the move. Close, continue. And here we have Captain Clayton. The good thing about Entangled is that it actually affects undead. You can entangle them. But it's not as reliable as Immobilized, for example, or Freeze. But in order to affect someone, of course, your card has to have potential higher than their level. So only potential 3 cards can affect Captain Clayton, who is level 3. So we build up some retribution. We'll let Captain Clayton get this. He didn't attack. So the skeleton is the receiver of our 6 retribution damage. Okay, so now we got to entangle Captain Clayton. Level but up. We can also finish him off, just to be sure. And I will replace this wall of vine here with this boar. If you have more than the allowed allies, the one in the first spot will go away. to make space for the new one. And I will finish the skeleton before he gets to shield himself. So our retribution damage goes to the zombie sailor, and we can finish him off. We cleared the first stage. I will discard the pump, in fact, put it in my stash. And increase my agility to 15, get some perks. We can get the apprentice summoner, which will make our allies stronger. And also herbal lore, which will give us access to herb skill. So let's add the herb skill to our deck. Remove the ceremonial masks. And I will actually remove this wall of vines, add some more primal cards, and remove these entangles, so we'll be playing a bit more offensively. Of course, my deck needs to be shuffled for these changes to get the maximum effect. But in the meantime, we can so we got the unwilling transformation. I will play this card to get the synergy primal and use it with this primal slashing card, the sixth sense, and also feral strike. Remember that while you are transformed, you discard any non-primal card you draw. You can of course remove the unwilling transformation, but what's what will happen to these guys with our primal slashing cards? So I play close strike. All my primal cards got a plus one. And I will play the Animal Instinct. Now I will also have the Synergy, which will make it a Primal Slashing 5. So all of these cards now got a boost. It also has the Synergy of Primal Slashing 8. And you basically can clean up the entire table using the primal fury of the Lycanthrope. Sealed it up again. Of course, if you don't have a good amount of primal cards in your deck, then this might not be as advantageous as it could be. This shielding skeletons is troublesome because
no, what else is new?
This is the gloom pot, and we can inflict vulnerable and also give doom if the enemy has vulnerable counters, but neither of these cards can help us against the undead. Pride also is not worth spending in this enemy. So I will finish him off with my pets. Let's open the chest. XP card, I will get the lucky horse shoe. So our allies are about to go away. I will get the melancholy, it's not a reaction, and it will mutate, but it will mutate to a gloom reaction. And these allies also, he has a reaction and he doesn't have a special, so it's okay. Let's use gloom. Inflict doom. I will take the Marupian Vulgari. And the way spell components work is that, unlike synergies, they stack. So if, for example, I will play this Marupian Vulgari here, the next card I will play, if it's a spell component, it won't trigger these synergies but add its own synergy to them. Whereas if I play a non-spell component card, I will use up these synergies. So for the sake of example, I will also play Potentilla Uva Ursi. And now my next action will get all three effects. It will inflict weaken, inflict frozen, and also in pride of 7. And what Pride does is, if the enemy has less than 7 power, it will deal to them damage equal to their power, so 3 and 1. Let's play this card. The fledgling sorceress died and got replaced by this nice zombie ally because of the doom effect. The doom effect is something you will mostly find in the Necromancer class, but the Gloomy Pot has this ability as well. So allies is a good way to get abilities you normally wouldn't have, like for example this affliction card is a Necromancer card, my character wouldn't have it. But thanks to the Gloomy Poet we got the zombie, and thanks to the zombie we got affliction, which doesn't help us much because we don't have dark affinity. In fact, our dark affinity is penalized, but it can still weaken. Good unwilling transformation, we switched to our hybrid form and let's continue. We can right click to craft the card and also inflict this primal damage. Pick a herd, I don't mind having the entangle target me. I And herbs are also an excellent way for us to get access to effects that we normally wouldn't have. I will equip the teeth medallion. And also switch to the spiked club. The apprentice staff has this nice defend bonus, but I feel that the spiked club matches more this character in flavor, that is. But, let's try to bewitch one of these huntresses, maybe this one. I will play the component and activate it with my ally ability. I can also summon the gloomy pod. She didn't got stunned. And melancholy, if you don't. Melancholy costs zero. So we could inflict. We can use it to inflict vulnerable, but we can also use this ally here to attack. Cornwell has a dark resistance, unfortunately. So let's end our turn. Level up. Our retribution killed the scout Andres. Finish him with my wolf, and I will use the gloomy poet to attack here. I stand here so she won't heal, and I will finish him with my wolf. Let's take a look. What's new here from what our mastery allows us is the animist cards, and in particular we can take speak with birds, we can take animus. Speak with birds, we used it in draft. You get to choose a random card or a random card, and if speak with birds is active, that means it's echoing and has duration more equal than 3. This check can only succeed at the second turn of when this action is has a level 2 upgrades. So once it's a level 2 card, the second time it triggers, it will activate this conditional check here. We have Invigorate, which also reactivates an ally. So I will go like this, and from here put the gloomy poet to my stash and the Bishwarm as well. I will actually trigger these two consumables right now. So we will get to 22 cards. This will deal 1-2 damage to my character, it's okay. Get the armor. Get the weapon. And we can actually equip this armor here. And for pecs now, we can take either Tenacious or Inhuman Strength. Or Athletic, which will boost Strength, Agility and Resilience. But I will take Tenacious. and I will take attunement and increase my agility. So what Animus does is it allows us to summon stronger allies. Now if I was to take this Animus Viribus, which would be the optimal, my next action will cost 2 action points more, so I won't be able to... I actually might be able to summon my wolf. So I will play the Animus Viribus and now commune with wolves. And this is a 4-9, 14 hit points and 6 lifespan wolf, which is much stronger than what this wolf was. He came to us. This is a level 2 wolf, so he will benefit from the teamwork. This bonus is from our teeth medallion. Let her die from bleeding. Herbal lore. I will get the Amanita Diokia so we can heal. You also get a penalty in the piercing damage, which doesn't in particular affect us because this is primal slashing. And we can use this nice invigorate card to attack twice with our ally. No need to spend it now, no need to do anything in fact. This to the deck, get the order of chain, get the animate vines, you never know when we will need some ranged cards for flying enemies. But what you need to keep in mind is that your allies can always attack and can always harm flying targets. So if you are back into the corner and face flying targets, then make sure to bring in as much as allies as you can. And all the races have access to allies. Let's speak with birds. Use ceremonial mask, use herbal infusion. Bring our wolf. Zombie horde. Let's build some retribution. I don't in particular care about the Trip Wolf attack. I reactivated him so I can attack like so. And to also get the synergy of Retribution. Assuming none of them attacked though. Let's get the Sloth synergy. What Sloth does is discard your entire hand and then deal damage equal, not this Sloth, the card, the action effect we care about. Target suffers X damage plus 2 for each card in your hand. Discard your hand. And we will be triggering Sloth by right clicking our wolf ally. So discarded our hand. So unfortunately, he is resistant to Earth. So got killed power or retribution damage. Let's try. Got our board dealt 2 damage. More zombie hordes, and let's use this feral strike. Actually, yes, I will use the feral strike, and let's use the reaction first. Now, if you notice that your character is struggling with action points, and we can regenerate 7 per turn, but we are already spending for our leather armor, and we are spending for our teeth medallion, so you can deactivate those and give yourself some breathing space. Let's bring one more wolf. He will attempt to dispel us, and he will stay entangled. That's a good outcome too. And our hit points are pretty low, so let's find some cards that can heal our character. Maybe we don't have something. We can use Herbal Lore. Get the Bulk Erythrea. So 6 cents. Summon a powerful boosted boar. And build up our retribution and defend. It's 12 retribution. I will put them like so, so he will die, get 6, and then get another 6 to him. He flanked us, so he didn't got any retribution. They have to actually attack you in order to get the retribution damage. The pride component, and also speak with the birds. I will get this card so it can unravel. This will help us replenish more action points as we move on. Get the fog plate now, so we can benefit from its echo in our next turn. And this to unravel. And I will use the pride component. And activate it in my club. I will also use the Animus with a power boost for my wolf. I have to play the component first. Boost it and bust it. We'll also summon our boar with the same power component, but in the next turn, because I can't afford it right now. I'll just play this card to get the defend and retribution bonus. Keep the attack going by summoning an additional companion. He doesn't take any bludgeoning damage. What a beast. He has a 4 bludgeoning resistance. So pretty tough to kill. But you can still manage. And actually we can have 4 allies at a time, because we got the perk and didn't got advantage of it yet, because I forgot. It happens. Unwilling transformation. Our pack helped us survive the rough dungeon. We can visit the town, check the pets and mercenaries, and I will be adding, or try to add, this woodland dryad here to my deck. That is, if we get to find here cheaper before. It's nightfall, 380, 5 o'clock. Remember that stores close if you let the time pass at evening. This is an option that you can set in on game mode basis. So if you don't want the store to close, have the time not advance in these settings. You can mod everything as you see fit in Air on Earth. Okay, so this fire wasp, if we don't kill it, will take flight in the next turn, and only our allies will be able to harm it, because Lycanthrope doesn't have much of ranged cards. They do have some vines. No, this is for the Animist part, sorry. So yes, the only way for me to damage this Fire Wasp when it takes flight would be with my allies. And Lycans have many allies, not just the wolves. You get even more down the road. Let's play Animus. Animus Viribus Summon. This to unravel. And we have a mimic. We don't know much about it yet. We have to defeat one so we can learn what does it do.
Oh no.
It has illusory co.
Oh no.
Okay, two flying enemies. Let's deal with the toughest one first. Bleeding Strike, that gives us an opportunity to bring him below half. If he was below half, he wouldn't be able to take flight. Our bleeding will do the trick and prevent him from getting flight. And now he will die from bleeding. So this ranged card is actually part of the Animist, part of our Lycanthrope.
I'll make sure no one gets hurt, okay?
Okay, good. We were hoping for that. So get some healing back and boost our retribution. He choose to flank. Enemies always choose to flank. They will try to harm you when their hit points are at their fullest, and they have this tactic, of course. Or they will shield, they will use their defensive stance if they are harmed. So first item in their agenda is to actually survive and harm you if they can. Let's get the bomb. And at this point we are in Loa. Let's use the Sassafras Albaidum. All the bombs in deck. And we have enough. needs to cover. This will protect her from ranged attacks, but we don't have much of ranged attacks. Our wolf can harm her. And let's sacrifice him by also killing this skeleton. And that's it. The end or a new beginning. Let's see what we got. So we got 6 tokens and 5 and 10. And last time I was at 2. Now we have 28 tokens acquired in this particular run. We also got some nice Lycanthrope mastery, and we can get to unlock our next race, class, which is the Necromancer. And since we have some more time to play, let's do a vampire Necromancer run. And for the Necromancer, we care about dark and a bit of Blazionic. Let's pick a lady this time. And a shot shootable Necromancer character. Here, for example. And I will go with willpower, because willpower increases our dark damage. Just 2 points of intellect for the hand size. Charisma also increases dark, but in a more minor way. So let's go like so. And we can name here Lorelei. Playing casual. Check our deck. And we can have up to 6 skeletal minions, which is the backbone of the Necromancer deck. It's this card right here, which summons an ally. And we can have some supplementary offensive spells, as well as 1 healing and 3 feed cards from the vampire side. That's feed, that's fast healing. And this is the deck we'll be playing with. I will also get the corrupt perk, which increases the dark damage we deal. Summon a skeleton, get the unquestionable loyalty. Continue. So I will get the empowered deck dead card to show you how it works. Even though it's similar to what we saw in the Hunter example with the wolf training. Also, keep in mind that when you deal the death blow with your apprentice staff, you get to become empowered, And when you are empowered, I will get this quarterstaff. When you are empowered, all your cards are much stronger. Let's get this offhand and one bomb. So this offhand here, I will have to unequip my apprentice staff to use an offhand, because this is a two-handed weapon. I need two hands to hold it, since I don't want to. Let's continue. So keep in mind that your feed also deals piercing damage, so it can harm the target even if they immobilized and the drain don't kick in. Let's get another empowered head. And since we haven't been using them, because I keep adding them to my discard pile, I can now reduce this affliction, chill touch, necrotic bolt, maybe one doom. No, I will put this elixir in my stash actually. And do a shuffle. Now you might wonder, why did I use the card? So it can gain XP, because these allies in particular are fleeting. So using the empowered dead in an unexhausted ally, I will exhaust him and also trigger the teamwork power and the teamwork health, which is 2 plus the level and 4 plus the level bonus of power and health for your next sum. This one, a much stronger skeleton. Let's
level up.
Have to worry only about Mina. When you are empowered, your card's potential is much higher. It's your empower is added to your card potential, and that's the main reason we were able to stun our boss enemy with a level 0 card. Now, if you remember, Affliction was pretty weak when we are a Lycanthrope, but now it's pretty strong. Started a Grimoire. Let's get Hunting Grounds. Let's put him in the front so it gets replaced by this one. So empower plus the empower dead card, created the ultimate skeleton. Well, it can get better, but he's the ultimate skeleton among them at least. Put him in the front, so your next skeleton, and keep the attack going. Your dead servants are replaceable. Is as good as cleared. Continue. And let's get to increase our charisma and increase our willpower. The new card here is vampire cards, because we have High Master in Vampire and still can't unlock this Deteriorate and Compel Undead cards, but we will after our next Necromancer run. Blood Reading is interesting if we are playing with the Bleed archetype, and Lacerate too, but since we are working with a Summon deck, summoning based deck, will be using Recycle, this card right here, which can basically replace an about to go ally with let's use the class. Each time you would craft a reanimate card, you craft one more. Your synergy power effect increased by 3. No, I will take the Apprentice Summoner, which as we saw before, it's very good when you are playing with summoning decks. And also get the High heightened reflexes, so we can get more action point per tail. Let's start. I'll move in one. Bring the second empowered. Use the card on him. Summon our next skeleton, like so. Also get to keep a zombie ally. Study the grimoire. I will get a blood ritual. Let's put this first, because Doom, the card Doom, instead of in addition to inflicting Doom, it also has this kill property that might actually kill an enemy. So we have 5, this one will go away now, when we click and turn, and also any the Chained Vampire. We don't have the bosses here, so I don't think we have much time to see the Songpertent Nightingale in action. But let's shuffle my deck. Here it is, and let's get rid of the... I can use Empowered Dead to bring in a stronger Nightingale and replace this ally. This is a vampire, and if you use this turn only, the Carmenest this, it will convert this Nightingale here into the Songbird, which is this card right here. And she has a different special, the Canticum de Sirenimbus, which bewitches the living, while she has the Canticum Mortis, which pains, damages the undead. We are past 1 hour, so I will just move ahead to the boss, skip even the town. Now, remember that multicast cast targets the first enemies in the battlefield. So, in your enthusiasm to finish the stage, don't forget such crucial details. Thank you. speak another blood ritual. And I was telling you about recycle. What it does, it let's say this undead right here is no longer useful because it will expire. I can recycle them. This will sacrifice their ally. I will restore hit points equal to the remaining hit points this ally have minus 3. That was 8. And this skeleton will take its place, which has defend and retribution as an ability. And I can also use the doom here. And some more ally. While empowered, let's teamwork this ally because it's level 2, so we get to summon with power and health of plus 6. Our next skeleton. So what you should be striving for as a necromancer is to summon an army of strong undead allies, and this one will go away, so we can just recycle. Groggle. Not sure if you remember his counter attack and how much trouble he gave us the first time we saw him. He's a level 7. Can't stun him unless perhaps I'm empowered. Let's see, our potential is 6. Still can't stun him. I could if this was a level 2 card. But it's not. Okay, that was really good. Because now, should I risk for the fit to kill him? Of course, because that's how it thinks. Work. And with this, my friends, we cleared casual one more time. Reincarnate, and you are 5 tokens away from your next class. So as you can see, our progress is pretty good. We have already unlocked 3 races and 2 classes, and on our way for the third, and all that with a few short runs that you can be easily doing in like 30 minutes. It's 1 hour and 10, and I've been talking you through 2 runs. If I was just like it would probably. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.